guys, welcome back to Kerbal Space Program 1.4. Last Saturday I was doing a stream exploring all the new features of Kerbal Space Program 1.4. Yes, so good, I'm going to say it twice. That was mainly consisting of parachuting over the sands of Lathe and the Pogo of Doom. Shortly afterwards, I was approached by wise in my Discord channel who was saying, "Hey, Twitchi, you're good at the parachute thing. You should have a go at this challenge." And so it was on. I've got myself in here an Ares 3. It's just nice and easy to fly around in. Absolutely nothing to do with the challenge. What is to do with the challenge is throwing myself from said craft, plummeting a long way. Now, this is actually a really long way. So I will kick us on up to times 600 speed here, as we all know Kerbal takes a little bit of time to get going. But as I'm coming down close to the ground, I'm like, should really be thinking about deploying my parachute here. I've been using my RCS almost the entire way down to try and get myself in a nice line, but as we come down, we are going exceedingly fast. So I feel like I need to burn off a little bit of speed. This also works in planes as well. If you find that you're going far, far, far too fast for your touchdown, you should definitely consider doing circles up and down waves, stuff like that. But it makes it nice and easy. Little, nearly fall off the edge there, but everything works out a-okay for me. And that is part one of my challenge complete. Land on top of the air traffic control tower. No problem there. This time, I decided to bail out really, really early, but also deploy everything super early as well. So as you can tell, we're going to take a little bit of time to get on down here. Part two of this challenge consists of trying to land myself inside the air traffic controller's box, that little office up on top with the nice big windows. Thankfully, none of those windows are actually real glass. I mean, I suppose nothing is actually real in this game. It's all like simulation and numbers and colours on a screen. But that means that there is an open way up above there, so I should be able to try and land myself right in there. And yes, I can hit the window, but I can also end up on the other side. So this time I'm having that clear path through in a mind, and I'm trying to think how I can approach that with a little less speed. Now obviously these circles are not going to work out incredibly well for me, because that's going to mean that I don't have the best lineup to work with here. Almost every step of the way I'm like, I've got too much speed, I need to slow down. So I do some circles, I do some up and downs, and I try and make myself line up a-okay, and then just stall and fall out of the ground. So you know, that's good fun as well. This effort, I come in with a vast excess of speed, and despite many, many maneuvers to try and burn off some of that speed, I once again go flying through the other side so fast that I actually kill Valentina. Dangerous place, this. Anyway, after a series of what can only be described as near misses and very good efforts, I finally end up with some sort of scenario where I'm coming down very, very fast. And I've got something to show you here about what's going on when I get closer to the tower. If you watch my parachute up top, you can see it actually like morphed through the actual tower. So that's something to bear in mind. I learned something there. So with all the pieces in place, I'm like, yeah, okay, I've got an idea here. Let's try and make the plane crash into the tower before I land. I jump out, and what only can be described as a fierce spaghettification happens. I have a look around and try and find Valentina, but as you can see, everything is a little bit... So I move on to have another go. I still want to hit that tower, but I seem to have found a rather consistent spaghettifier. So that's all good fun. Anyway, this is what you guys are here for. This is the final attempt that I undertook. You can see me flying at roughly the speed of sound, about 5 kilometers up. We're going to do the entire run here because I feel you guys are owed it after sitting through and watching all my failed attempts. We're bailing out with Valentina. Still a nosedive attempt, but I decided not to aim exactly for the tower because this has led me to all sorts of troubles. I then bust out my RCS and try and spend a little bit of time aligning myself up. You can see the runway up ahead there. I try and have that as a horizontal line across my screen, so I can then just use my translate controls, my left and right strafe, if you will, to try and put me in a good and straight approach. It could be argued here that I deployed my parachute a little bit too early. I kind of understand that. The parachutes, as with all parachutes in the game, are possibly the most boring part of this entire game. The EVA, like, these ones are fairly fun, don't get me wrong, but they're only fairly fun when you're close to the ground and skimming along and doing things relatively risky. But anyway, we're coming down at about a 45 degree angle, trying to build up a little bit of speed, but of course, bearing in mind that I can shoot through both windows, I need to keep that speed relatively low. I'm also opening up my right click menu there, because if you will remember, my parachute phases through solid objects, so I want to try and do something with that. You can see that I'm going up and down to try and keep my speed fairly well limited. I'm also doing little S curves left and right to try that as well. Cut my parachute just as I get through the window, and bam! I have landed in there and called that challenge complete. So I think with that, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to say thank you very much for joining me for this adventure. Hopefully, some of you guys out there have got other ideas for challenges to do, because I would really like to come back to Kerbal Space Program 1.4 and do some challenges. But if you feel like you want to take this one on, do feel free to drop me a video down below. I would love to see that happen, and I will see you guys next time, where we're going to do all sorts of crazy things. Bye!